Welcome to Tis the Soundtrack, the podcast dedicated to digging deep and bringing you the merriest of music all year long. I'm your host, Kevin Williams, and as August comes to a close, we're rapidly approaching that special night where a magical being descends from the sky to share the gifts of joy and merriment. That's right. In just a few short days, Jeff Lynne will arrive in Portland, Oregon for ELO's Over and Out final tour. To celebrate this sacred night, we're taking a look today at the Christmas music contributions of Jeff Lynne and his Electric Light Orchestra. Jeff Lynne is sadly not the household name he should be. In interviews, Lynne has stated he much prefers putting in long days at the mixing desk to living the rock star life, an ethos that has likely contributed to his ability to build a staggering resume over the last 50 years while remaining fairly under the pop culture radar. Going back to the beginning, ELO started as a side project of the English band The Move, an outlet for them to explore the fusion of early 70s rock and classical music. Roy Wood, the other creative force in ELO, left shortly after the release of their first self-titled album in 1971. This left Jeff to chart the course through another 14 albums from 1973's ELO 2 to 2019's From Out of Nowhere. But ELO's heyday was squarely the latter half of the 1970s, where Lynne produced a series of albums from Face the Music in 75, on through the Xanadu soundtrack in 1980, all cracking the top 10 of the US Billboard 200 chart. This run is responsible for hits including Evil Woman, Strange Magic, Telephone Line, Livin' Thing, Sweet Talkin' Woman, Don't Bring Me Down, and the title track Xanadu featuring Olivia Newton-John. This period also produced an ELO song that, while not initially a chart topper, has gone on to become their most recognizable tune, Mr. Blue Sky, from the 1977 album Out of the Blue. This song has been everywhere recently, from the opening credits of the Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 movie, to the closing of the Super Mario Bros. Movie, not to mention being featured in both the opening and closing ceremonies of the 2012 Summer Olympic Games in London, and, my personal favorite appearance of the song, a cover version by the Muppets band Dr. Teeth and the Electric Mayhem, produced for Google's Dear Earth special in 2021. Quick tangent. Mr. Blue Sky was almost the theme song for the American version of The Office. When Greg Daniels first adapted The Office, he was originally intent on using an existing song for the show's theme. As Jenna Fisher shared on her podcast, Daniels had narrowed it down to three choices: Better Things by The Kinks, Float On by Modest Mouse, and Mr. Blue Sky. Daniels cut opening sequences using each song and sent them to the cast to vote on. Mr. Blue Sky was the overwhelming winner. In fact, it was set to be the theme song for so long that the DVD containing the cast pilot also included it. But before the first episode of The Office aired, another NBC show, LAX, which starred Heather Locklear, debuted and also used Mr. Blue Sky for its opening theme. So Daniels turned to James Ferguson to record the original, now iconic, Office theme. And that's history. And since we're already on a tangent, I'll take another moment for a small shout-out to another of my favorite ELO songs, Do Ya, from the 1976 album A New World Record. The song, which hasn't received a lot of attention over the years, was thrust into the spotlight recently when it was featured in all the trailers for the new Borderlands movie. And while I've not seen the movie yet, I'll go out on a limb and predict that the trailer featuring a 30-second montage of action sequences set to Do Ya is better than watching the actual movie. That's just a guess. Okay, back on topic. Outside of his work steering the ELO ship, Lynne has also notched a pair of solo albums and continues to add to his list of writing and producing credits, including his work with Bryan Adams, Tom Petty, Roy Orbison, George Harrison, Ringo Starr, Paul McCartney, Brian Wilson, and Joe Walsh. Lynne also has the distinction of being the least known member of the Traveling Wilburys, a musical supergroup that included Bob Dylan and the aforementioned Tom Petty, Roy Orbison, and George Harrison. When the Beatles were assembling the anthology series, it was Jeff they turned to and entrusted to produce two new tracks, Free as a Bird and Real Love, both based on demo tapes recorded by a post-Beatles John Lennon. So, now that we've spent a few minutes catching up on Lynne's musical credentials, we can look at his contributions to the Christmas music tapestry, which include exactly zero songs. That's right, over 50 years of writing, producing, and recording, and there isn't a single Jeff Lynne or ELO Christmas track. Nothing, nada, zilch. So, you might be asking what we're doing here today. Well, first, this episode gave me a reason to talk about Jeff Lynne, and it's an opportunity I was not going to miss. And second, while not directly responsible for creating any Christmas tunes, Lynne has indirectly left his mark on the holidays in several ways over the years, which is exactly what we'll be digging into now. To start, we're going to look at a pair of Christmas adverts that prominently feature ELO. The first is a JCPenney commercial that I've mentioned in a previous episode. It was from their 2005 Unwrap the Magic campaign, and featured the ELO song Livin' Thing, also from the album A New World Record. The premise of the advert is that holiday shopping online, something that was still fairly novel in 2005, is like magic. And the commercial depicted a giant mouse cursor dragging gift boxes to family members in a living room and clicking to transform them into their unwrapped presents. The advert uses the first verse of the song, emphasizing the "it's like magic" lyrics, before a voiceover starts stomping on top of it.
Can a few clicks of a mouse really make the holidays more magical? It all depends on how you look at it.
It ends by cropping out the third line of the chorus, "it's a given thing," which I'm guessing was used to punctuate the commercial, since given, E-N, sounds close to giving, I-N-G.
This is the shape of the holiday season. JCPenney.com.
Which brings up a at least interesting to me question. Looking at the gifts in the commercial, I have to ask, who was buying their expensive telescopes and guitars from JCPenney in 2005? From the assortment of gifts shown in the ad, I think the most plausible gifts were the Jeff Gordon NASCAR jacket and the BMX bike with the fake dirt bike facade. The second, and in my opinion much better use of ELO music, is the 2014 Kohl's Yes to Holiday Magic advert, a much more sentimental affair featuring Strange Magic from the Face the Music album. The setup for this one is a dad and his preteen son driving down the road into a snowy wooded area. The dad starts to explain that the son's mom and he thought the son might like this, and I'm finger quoting, and how his dad had brought him out here when he was young, but he stops when he realizes the kid has earbuds in and isn't listening. They park the car at the edge of the woods and walk in as an arrangement of Strange Magic starts playing. They come to a clearing and see a Santa-esque fellow in front of a cabin feeding a herd of reindeer. One of the reindeer approaches the sun, then, after a brief staring contest, it tears off into the fog, and you see it start to take flight just as it disappears.
Dad, did you see that?
For the second one, the lyrics come in during the last part, as the reindeer takes off. They're a mashup of four separate lines plucked from the end of the first verse and various points in the chorus. But it works. It actually works really well, the whole thing, the commercial and the music. And I'm probably not doing either of these commercials justice in how bad the first one was or how heartfelt the second one was, so you can look them up yourself. The links are in the show notes. I did a bit of searching, though full disclosure, not too much searching, to see if the commercial version of the song exists anywhere else. But it looks like it was created specifically by the Peterson Miller Hooks agency for this advertisement. Another quick tangent. The son in the commercial is Anton Starkman, who a year later played Max Ellison in a handful of episodes of American Horror Story Season 5, and who more recently played Milo, a comic book shop manager and lead character in the Nickelodeon series Warped. So good for him. Christmas magic and a respectable acting career. Not too bad. While I was only able to find two holiday commercials featuring ELO, there are still a couple more Jeff Lynne Christmas connections, and this one's probably the biggest. I mentioned at the beginning of the episode that ELO was initially a side project of the band The Move, and that shortly after their first album, creative differences caused Roy Wood to leave the group. He left to start another project, a new band, with the intent of stitching together early 60s rock and that wall of sound style that Phil Spector was making popular. That band was Wizard, the same Wizard that released I Wish It Could Be Christmas Every Day about a year later in 1973. The song, which was voted the UK's second favorite Christmas song in The Nation's Favorite documentary series, just behind the Pogues' Fairy Tale of New York. Well, I wish it could be Christmas every day. So, in a way, if it wasn't for Jeff Lynne joining The Move and then forcing Roy Wood to go a different direction, we might not have one of the greatest Christmas songs of the 1970s. Or, I suppose in an alternate timeline, Wood would have stayed, and we'd have an ELO version of the song instead. But let's not dwell on that one. Jeff also notches another Christmas connection through his production of Tom Petty's holiday tune, Christmas All Over Again, which appeared in both Home Alone 2 and Very Special Christmas 2, the second album in a compilation series benefiting the Special Olympics.
Well, it's Christmas time again.
The final and most recent Jeff Lynne connection is the 2022 holiday track "It Was a Silent Night, At Least Until Jeff Lynne Arrived" by the band Gandaddy. The song, set to Silent Night, is the tale of an unexpected holiday visit from Jeff Lynne. On Bandcamp, frontman Jason Light shared, "Santa Claus gave me some pretty cool gifts as a kid, but I have to say that Jeff Lynne has given me about a million or so more. Here is my little, light-hearted holiday combo homage to the two of them." And with that, we've reached the end of our dive into Jeff Lynne and ELO's Christmas music exploration. Before we depart, since we've talked about a few non-Christmas songs, I want to take the opportunity to run each one of them through the Chrismometer, our highly tuned 5-point Christmas music scale that rates the holidayness of a song from Bing Crosby's White Christmas at the top all the way down to Edgar Wintergroup's Frankenstein at the bottom. For the songs discussed today, we have Livin' Thing coming in at a 1.25. A great song, but you aren't going to squeeze much more Christmasness out of it than you are out of Edgar Winter. Strange Magic at 2.75. Another great song, and if we can assume the magic is Christmas-related, we're squarely in Fleet Foxes' White Winter Hymnal territory. Wizards' I Wish It Could Be Christmas Every Day at a solid 3.9, which means it's just a hair less Christmassy than Dean Martin singing Winter Wonderland. Christmas All Over Again at 3.75, putting it in solid Christmas territory. And then the Chrismometer just didn't know what to do with It Was a Silent Night, At Least Until Jeff Lynne Arrived. Looking at the pile of wreckage on the floor, I'm going to guess it's either a 6 or a negative 1. I'll leave that one for you to decide. Livin' Thing and Strange Magic can both be found on the Stealth Christmas playlist, a curated list of non-Christmas, Christmas-adjacent tunes published to YouTube and Tidal. You can find the link in the show notes or at tisthesoundtrack.com. There are also links in the show notes to all the songs and advertisements we discussed in this episode. Thank you for coming along again, and thank you for listening to Tis the Soundtrack. This is Kevin Williams saying cheers and Merry Christmas.
Jeff Lynne, oh Jeff Lynne, he's at the door. Let's let him in with his guitar and a Jupiter 8 and gingerbread cookies piled high on a plate. He showed up out of the blue.